gentlemen, to Crusader Kings 2, The Wolf's Revenge. It is I, the Golden Joeblivion. We're back with our man, the legendary Lord Paramount Eddard of the North. And last time, Aegon Targaryen invades. Before I hop into this, I just want to give you guys a few updates because it seems like the best way to get everyone on the same page. We have the 1 year anniversary of the channel coming up, the end of the first week of May. And I intend to have a little bit of an equipment upgrade. We should get a little face reveal going on here, a little bit of a webcam action. I don't know where we're going to put my lovely face here in the screen, but soon I will be a part of the series as well, so I'm very excited about that. We can look forward to that. God damn it, what else? I had a bunch of other things. For everyone who's leaving comments in the comment section, I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for all of the interaction and involvement. I love it. Unfortunately, the channel has grown to a point where keeping up with comments is becoming very difficult. It's not uncommon for me to put out my more popular videos and come home after working at the day job to find 20, 30 comments that I have to respond to. And that could literally take an hour, almost two, just responding and reading everyone's comments. So I just want to say if you are contributing in the comments section, keep on doing that. I really appreciate it. If for whatever reason I don't get to your comment, I don't reply, I don't heart it, or if I don't implement something you suggest for the series, do not take it personally. It's just because sometimes it's difficult to remember everything that people are suggesting, and sometimes people suggest different things. They offer conflicting ideas, and that's always awesome. There's been a lot of great discussions, especially for this series, about what Lord Paramount Eddard Stark should do, would do in the lore, in the show, etc. I'm very, very interested in reading those kind of back and forths, and overall, you guys have maintained a rather civil discourse, and I appreciate that. It really, really goes a long way to talk about the type of community we have here on the channel. God damn it, there's something else I was going to say, but I've already forgotten. We have changes, developments in Westeros. Aegon Targaryen invades. A young silver-haired man has landed in Westeros, claiming to be Aegon. Oh god, I still don't know Roman numerals. Shit. Okay, Aegon, two-born son of Rhaegar Targaryen, rightful king of the Seven Kingdoms, is widely believed that he perished in the Red Keep at the hands of Sir Gregor Clegane during the War of the Usurper, along with his sister Rhaenys and mother Aelia of Dorne. It is reported that it was not Aegon who perished there, but some peasant baby who was just conveniently around to replace Aegon. Now that this claimant lands and he has the Golden Company at his back. Now, when I first read this, I think I was still Team Stannis. But after reading the discourse going on in the comments section, I think I've come around to be more pro Aegon. I know Lord Paramount Eddard probably wouldn't like the Targaryens, considering how terrible they were to his family, but I think technically Aegon would have the rightful claim. Now, true, the Targaryens were deposed, but not entirely. They weren't all wiped out. And I actually listed all of the... So essentially, King Aegon would have the strongest claim. Dany would have the second strongest claim. Aegon is actually here in Westeros right now with the Golden Company backing him. Dany has dragons, baby dragons, but she seems to be more content to stay here in Slaver's Bay. We offered her a betrothal with Rickon Stark, you know, offering her some kind of tie to Westeros, and she said, nah, she doesn't care about that. So I don't know if she's even going to come to Westeros. We'll see. After those two, there is Stannis, who, as far as we can tell, will not actively pursue his own... Well, he's not outright fighting for his claim. He's willing to conspire with factions to put him on the throne, but he's not willing to actually fight right now for his claim. And the same thing goes for Renly. So the only one who's actively fighting for their claim right now is Aegon Targaryen, and he just happens to have the strongest claim. And he has a lot of men supporting him. So I think Eddard Stark would feel... And plus, some people have talked about, well, Eddard knew that his sister Lyanna Stark was in love with Rhaegar, and they secretly got married, and they gave birth to Jon and stuff. So some people said that Eddard wouldn't actually have as much hatred for the Targaryens. It was mainly Aerys who was the one to blame, but Rhaegar was relatively innocent, although his running away and getting secretly married to Lyanna Stark for love did make the realm bleed. So that was not cool, not cool. But I think we will support Aegon Targaryen's claim. I've never seen Aegon Targaryen take over. I know Aegon would be very pleased if we were to help him. And it would be best to get this vicious boy off the Iron Throne. This boy who would have taken our head if he was given the opportunity to. So your alert from Eddard the Realm is in a state of war, and as such, I, as your liege king, command that you provide men to support my armies. We will not do that. We will join with Aegon. He's got 10,000 men. What kind of allies does he have? He has no allies at the moment. This could be very dangerous for us, though. It would be honorable to fight for Aegon. But I don't know what kind of allies he's going to have. Stannis is not going to like it. Renly's not going to like it. And as far as our allies go, who are our allies? We have House Tyrell. House Tully, I mean. Mace Tyrell actually has gone to disliking us. Provoked. Oh, yeah. We did provoke him by accident. Let's see. House Martell should aid Aegon. Should. That's the key word. So, I mean, Aegon lands, the Stormlands get fucking invaded, he takes over the Stormlands, Dorne assists him, the North assists him, we can pull the Trident into this. How about the Vale? Probably not. We can maybe make them remain independent, though. And some people did suggest breaking the betrothal with the Vale because Robert's probably going to die, and I have to agree, he tends to get wiped out by diseases. And Aegon right now actually doesn't... Where is Aegon? Where is the man? Where does he land? I forget. Where is he? Oh, no, you know what? He's unlanded. He's actually unlanded at the moment. Okay, so let's go to defending against Lord Paramount Baelon. So the Iron Throne's already waging a civil war, and they're being invaded by Aegon. We could arrange a marriage between... How old is Arya? Arya is 11. Okay. Sansa. Who is Sansa married to? Sansa is married to, betrothed to Lord Renly, who will become an enemy. And who is actually fighting for the Iron Throne. Maybe we break the betrothal with Lord Paramount Renly, which is going to make all of the Renly fans hate me. But I think Sansa would be better off married to Aegon, although she could die in that regard. And plus, you know, he's kind of got a little fertility penalty as well. He very well could be an enemy. Well, how about this? Well, I mean, let's fight for the rebels and we'll see what Renly does. If he fights for the Iron Throne, we're going to break this betrothal and we're going to try to marry Sansa to Aegon. I know we could do the same thing with Arya, but Arya's still kind of young and I'd like Arya to be kind of the link to the Vale. Because the Stormlands now is going to get overrun by Aegon. The Reach might actually fight us. Which would mean we could imprison Margaery. I don't want to, but we could. No, we're going to fight for the rebels. We will aid Aegon in his endeavors. Let's see, we're now fighting King Joffrey. And he likes us because we fought for him, I suppose. Usurped title. What? I didn't take your goddamn title, you son of a bitch. Which apparently... Oh, maybe he thinks that because we fought against his father, joined my war, joined cause. Right. So, because he thinks that we usurped his title, he's going to hate us for some time. For actually another century, it seems. All right, you son of a bitch. Let's try swaying King Aegon. I mean, we should be trying to sway the Reach, but... Okay. So apparently no one has joined... the Vale has not joined with Aegon. The Craven Rorg Slate has failed the call to arms. All right. So let's go ahead and get Sansa. Sansa. You are betrothed to Renly. You're not fighting for Aegon. I'm surprised. Oh, because Aegon landed up here. Ah, gotcha. Well, we are at war, so let's get the men. We will march the men. Can we call our allies into the war? Let's see. Attacking King Joffrey. Hostile towards King Aegon due to conflicting wars for the throne of the Seven Kingdoms. Our allies have become hostile. That's kind of concerning. Let's go ahead and march our men. What kind of supply limit do we got here? 28, 18, 24. Grey Water Watch. Yep, that'll be the way to do it. All the rest of yous? Ooh. Total troops in the county. Total troops when we arrive. I think we're going to be going through attrition. Yes. Okay, march the rest of Mokalen. We'll do that. Alright, that's what we'll do. We'll marshal the men. I don't know if we should break the betrothal with Renly in the Stormlands. Marrying Aegon would be great for getting a Stark on the Iron Throne, assuming that Aegon even wins. He might not. Does he have any allies that have come to aid him? I think I've looked at this three times now. Damn it. Renly! Renly! Oh, you don't like us. War enemy. We're war enemies now. How dare you, sir? Break that fucking alliance. Break that betrothal. Screw you, Renly. Where is Aegon? Aegon, I betrothed you. Wait a minute. What the hell? What is this? Arrange betrothal between Sansa and you. I can't. Why? I just broke a betrothal with Renly for no reason. You son of a bitch. Aegon, you son of a bitch. Why is he unmarriable? That's very odd to me. Uncrowned. Yeah, I don't know. I have no idea. Maybe supporting Aegon was the worst case scenario. Oh, shit. The wall is under assault and the Night's Watch is hard pressed to defend it. Oh, crap. King Mance Tall to- and the Wildlings invade. They're invading the wall at the same fucking time. Oh, fuck. All right. Well, Aegon, you're kind of on your own now because we need to aid the fucking Night's Watch. Shit. Who's the best supply limit up here? Ooh. All right. Go ahead and march your armies up there. And, I mean, we got some men that are marching down south. Or maybe we should march them up north as well. No, march them all the Greywater Watch. We gotta protect the neck. Damn it! Bastards. Well, unfortunately for Lord Eddard, things are not going quite as planned. Renly's not gonna be happy. Fuck that guy. All right, Aegon. Why can't we marry this fool? I don't understand. That's very strange to me. Is it because he's unlanded? I don't fucking know. And now the Vale is hostile to us. Our own allies are hostile to us. Oh, shit has just hit the fan, guys. All right. Spymaster Wyman, what do I want you to do? Let's build a spy network at King's Landing and see if we can't... Should we try to kidnap him? No, because we don't even have a chance for that. Let's... Benjamin of Hoarfrost Hill. Go ahead and sow dissent here in King's Landing as well. Let's just hit King Joffrey with everything we got. Just nuke him. Oh, man, this is going to destroy our treasury. Goddamn Wildlands. We need to end the war with the Wildlands as soon as possible. What is this? Wildling Revolt Army. And the Night's Watch has 2,000 men. How many men does Tall Talker got? 3,000. Oh, so he outnumbers... Queen Dalla. He outnumbers the Night's Watch by about 1,000 men. You know what? We don't need to throw all our men up there now. Let's just throw our men back down here. This army of 3,000. Being led by Rob. Oh, yeah, sweet. Supported by Lady Mage. And John. How about this? We'll have Theon aid Rob. As well as Hugo. Hugo. Yes. And then this army down here, we're going to have Eddard Stark. Eddard, please. Lady Mage. And John the Great John. They'll hold Greywater Watch. The Vale's... Oh, fuck. Oh, no, 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 no. We're the only ones aiding Aegon. Are you kidding? Mace Tyrell, the Vale, the Stormlands. Aegon, you've lost. And you may have just cost Eddard his head a second time. Shit. And Ars Martell is fucking off, not aiding Aegon. Wow. Okay. That was a really, really bad move. Fucking Targaryens. Can't trust them. Right, but the consternation of the fact that Lord Hugo enjoys command. Yeah, I know just how to soothe this over. There's a good chance that when Aegon loses, we could be fucked. If he just does a King's Landing rush, then that would do some. No, he's not. He's just gonna take. the Claw Isles or Crackclaw Lands or whatever the fuck. All right, let's get this army. Rob, aid the Night's Watch. Go to White Tree. They've moved on to Crestus Keep. All right, and we need to aid them. This should be good experience for Rob, assuming that House Stark doesn't get cast down for fucking supporting Aegon. God damn it. Fucking Aegon. He's about to get crushed. He's lost about 4,000 men through just attrition alone. Is there anything we can do? Anything we can do to make this not go badly for us? I don't know. We'll have to see. Oh, what the shit? Oh, yeah, we're gonna hang out in Castle Black, guys. Go back to Castle Black. Yeah, we'd have to make, like, a fort or something here in White Tree. There we go. Just protect Castle Black. Don't let, perhaps it could help me to increase King Aegon's opinion of me if I were to send him a gift. You know what? I don't think so. I don't think so, because this fool attacked with no allies, got almost half of his men killed through just attrition alone. Maybe taking some of these places which he's already lost. He has no allies. We were foolish and we attempted to aid him, and he won't even entertain ideas of marriage. So fuck that guy. Fuck that dude. Why can't we antagonize him? Does not have the trait honorable. Not fair enough. Well, he hates us now forever, conspired against me, dithered, joined rebellion. Yep. And there's nothing we can really do about it. Not good. And swaying, this guy is not going to help. The Westerlands are our enemies. And yeah, we might have royally fucked ourselves. Because here's the thing, we can hold the neck as long as we want, but they're going to send ships around to the north, and they're going to take everything else here. So we're kind of screwed in that regard. Ugh. This could be GG for Eddard Stark. This could be the beginning of the end. And I can only hope that the killing Aegon will satisfy their bloodlust. Maybe. It was a bad idea. It was a bad move, and that was my decision. King Aegon. Oh my god. Did we just dodge a bullet here? King Aegon of Aegon's Host War for the Iron Throne has ended inconclusively. News from the Battle of North Cracklaw, my lord. Your acquaintance, King Aegon of Essos, has been slain. He was killed in direct single combat by the enemy commander, Lord Jon Royce. Fucking Lord Jon may have saved House Stark. It's okay. So the reason I say that is because the war has ended inconclusively. It wasn't. There was no official end to the war, so they don't really. So King Joffrey shouldn't get any prompts to arrest us, in theory. Well, or to demand us to surrender ourselves. He could still arrest us because we've acted dishonorably towards him. In his mind. Has the civil war ended for him? Maybe. Let's see if the realm. Oh, we can't even see. Okay, I wanted to see what the realm authority was at. Okay, so we're no longer invading the south. We're still allies with House Tully. Lord Mace Tyrell hates us. Provoked war enemy. We're not war enemies anymore, asshole. All right. Get these men to Winterfell. We will deal with the, I'm gonna send Rob a raven. Let him know that it is now. Where'd Theon go? Is Theon in the Iron Isles? Oh. He is now ruler of the Iron Isles. Interesting. He doesn't really like us. The Iron Isles. Well, we can't really sway anyone else to like us. Renly now hates us forever. House Martell pretty much let Aegon die. Highgarden. I mean, what we could do, and this may be a bad idea, is we could arrange a marriage between Theon and Sansa. I don't like the idea of Sansa ending up with a squid, but, well, it's better than she would, you know, it's better than, well, It wouldn't make House Greyjoy an ally, and the Ironborn, while dishonorable, maybe Theon will be better. Maybe being raised by Eddard Stark and marrying Lady Sansa will make the Ironborn better. Probably not, but we gotta use Sansa for something. My bannerman, Lady Barbary Rizzo, has tried to have Lord Edwin Stout arrested. All right, that's cute. I'm gonna send a raven to Rob. I've decided to accept your suggestion. Good. Form an alliance. No. If you plan on invading us, I promise you, we will destroy you, Greyjoy. Give Rob the go-ahead. Let's give him the good commanders. Actually, you know what? Let's fucking aid Rob. Have Rob lead the center. We'll have the Great John, Rob, and Eddard. And we will move into White Tree, and we will establish a fort immediately. Oh, no. No. Oh, shit. Okay, this is bad. The fucking wildlings are making a move for the wall. We can't let them. Get back to Castle Black. Excellent. And they're moving in on Shadow Tower. They will have the defensive bonus of mountains, but I'm pretty sure, don't worry, Northern Valor. Northern Valor will see these bastards defeated. Let's see, is there any place in the north here that could support these men? Pretty much just Winterfell. Maybe we can just send, like, a contingent of men. Woo! Supported an usurper who then got killed in the battlefield. Aegon show. This series was really bad. Really bad. But we might have gotten lucky in that he was killed in battle. And now we're focusing on defending the wall against the Wildlings. The Wildlands betrothed can marry. Yep, go ahead. Marry Sansa to the squids. I don't like it, but I fucked up. I made the call to break the betrothal with Renly, and now Sansa has to marry Theon. Okay, well, it is what it is. All right, attack army of Chief Tormund. All right, this is Chief Tormund, right? Chief Tormund, Giant's Bane. Someone has suggested playing as the Giant's Bane, and I like the idea because I like Tormund, but in all honesty, I haven't had much luck playing as Wildlands. It's quite chaotic and dangerous, which can be fun. I just don't know if we would get rocked, you know, in the first episode or something. All right. We're going to be fighting over mountains. I accept your suggestion that Lady Sansa and Lord Paramount Theon get married. Good. In this mod, Theon looks a lot like Ramsay Bolton. It's very odd. Okay, and we are fighting the Wildlands over mountains. We have engaged with Tormund, the Giant's Bane, Chief Walrus the Great, and King Mance. So Lord John the Great John is going against King Mance. All right, let's see how this unfolds. They have us outnumbered by about 200 men, but that's okay because we have legions. Legions of Northern... What? Oh, an agreement has been reached. All right, they want a dowry. So we can give them a good dowry because we can afford it. Oh God, this is what happens. You drain all my money. You drain my money. You take my coin. Arya. Let's train her to be a good warrior because I think Arya would like that. Brandon, Rickon. All right. It seems we're getting the advantage of them. Oh shit. You're separated from your men in the chaos of battle, and now find yourself in the midst of war. As you scan the field and try to rejoin your forces, you see Chief Tormund break through the enemy ranks and charge you. Oh man, this would have been awesome to see in the show. Tormund Giant's Bane versus Ned Stark. See, he's a skilled fighter, and he's strong. Eddard is a skilled fighter. Ooh, we could throw Hallis. Hallis Mullen, our bodyguard. Captain of the Household Guard, Sworn Shield. He's a dead man. He is a dead man. No, Tormund is going to tear him apart. You know what? It's kind of weird because I feel like Eddard Stark would not want to send Hallis off to a pretty much guaranteed death. But at the same time, he's Captain of the Household Guard. He's Sworn Shield. He should be here to protect Lord Stark. Let's see. Tormund has 120 combat skill. That's fucking scary. And he's a hero. How do you get that? He's a hero? What is that shit? I want to be a hero. And Eddard Stark is a mere 95. We're probably dead, ladies and gentlemen. I don't think we're going to be able to best the Giant's Bane. All right, throw Hallis at him. Maybe Hallis can injure him. You look on in horror as Hallis falls to Chief Tormund, and he says, "It's over, my lord. This ends here." And it doesn't seem he did anything to the giant's bane. This is going to be bad, ladies and gentlemen. In the midst of battle, you and Chief Tormund circle each other, tensed and focused. The raging scene around you seems to slow down as you scan him for any sign of weakness, any opening in his defense that you could possibly exploit. We're younger than him. We might be able to be faster. He's a lot stronger than us. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, this could be it. This could be it for Lord Eddard. He met his end in the north, defending the north against the wildlings. Let's try for speed. I would say take a defensive stance, but they're both skilled fighters. I think Tormund would just see right through that. I think speed. Youth is the only thing helping Eddard. We'll attack with speed. You parry Chief Tormund away with ice, allowing you to effortlessly bring down your weapon on an opening in his defense. Strike! I easily break through Chief Tormund's guard and move to expertly smack my ice into the side of his head. He lies sprawled at my feet, completely at my mercy. He's gonna roll out of the way. You strike and manage to get the better of Chief Tormund, but do not defeat him outright. He rises to his feet and readies his long sword once again. Wait a minute. Concussion. This character has recently taken a blow to the head. I like how that doesn't affect his combat skill at all. It's just nothing. It's nothing to him. Oh, come on, Eddard. Come on. We got the better of him there. Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to leave this on a cliffhanger. I know you're going to hate me for it, but I think this would be the best time to end the episode. It's a little bit shorter than normal, but this is a fantastic point. High tension. We don't know what's going to happen to Lord Eddard. He's fighting for his life here in the Shadow Tower on the wall against the Giant's Bane, Tormund of all fucking people. And in the first round of the duel, we bested the Giant's Bane. But will Lord Eddard's luck hold out? We will have to find out in the next episode. Thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe as always. This has been Crusader Kings 2, The Wolf's Revenge. I have been the Golden Joeblivion. And until next time, I will see you all later.